The battle over abortion is always part of a presidential election, but this year it's the current administration's policies that have pro-life advocates really upset. Correspondent Shanna Bream explains why.
Pro-life advocates say the Obama administration is once again doing an end run around Congress, using executive power to change policy in a way dozens of GOP lawmakers say appears to be, quote, an attempt to subvert the will of elected representatives. The Department of Health and Human Services, or HHS, has proposed a federal regulation that will tell state and local governments how they can and cannot spend Title X money, which is given to states in order to fund family planning services. A number of states have set guidelines that direct the funds to full-service community health centers rather than Planned Parenthood, which performed nearly 325,000 abortions over the one-year period outlined in its most recent annual report. Planned Parenthood President Cecile Richards is praising the rule, saying, quote, the Obama administration is protecting access to health care for millions of people. Not everyone agrees.
Once again, you're going to have this administration that has an unholy alliance with the big abortion industry, protecting them and saying, states, you don't have the right to decide who provides the best services for your women, for women's health issues. We're going to tell you that you cannot make that decision. And you know what? That's wrong.
GOP Congresswoman Diane Black, who's also a registered nurse, has joined forces with GOP Senator Joni Ernst to author a letter urging HHS to reconsider. Quote, rarely do the American people benefit when the federal government attempts to substitute its judgment for that of state or local governments, particularly when the criteria used to inform that judgment are unclear and that judgment is not supported by coherent and impartial facts. In its proposed rule, HHS specifically cites attempts by New Hampshire, Texas, and Florida to essentially defund Planned Parenthood by directing Title X funds elsewhere, and says studies show those efforts lead to increased barriers to health care, especially among low-income and minority communities.
Critics, including Black, say much of the research relied on by HHS comes from a group that was not only named after a former Planned Parenthood president, but was also originally housed within Planned Parenthood's corporate structure. Comments on the rule are being accepted by HHS through October 7th. Brett.
Shanna, thank you. We'll follow that.